another great show brought to you by the Law of Attraction Radio Network. The Think, Believe, and Manifest Show with author and dream coach, Constance Arnold. Join us as we bring you life-changing information that will empower your life. And here's Constance.
Well, hello, everyone, and welcome to the Law of Attraction Radio Network. And I am Constance Arnold, your most gracious host. Okay, so how many of you desire to have more money in your life fast and now? Well, I want you to stay tuned because my very special guest, Ms. Carole Doré, will be sharing about Emergency Handbook for Getting Money Fast. In 1986, Carole founded PowerVision Dynamics, and she is now widely recognized as one of the leading authorities on the law of attraction and visualization, and she is an international speaker and the author of the highly sought-after book, The Emergency Handbook for Getting Money Fast. Carole, welcome to the Law of Attraction Radio Network. Well, let's talk about money. Money, honey. And I always say Les Brown says that money won't make you happy, but everybody wants to find out for themselves. And that next to oxygen, money is what most of us really desire. And so you have something really powerful, the Emergency Handbook for Getting Money Fast. So let's talk about that. Money. And I love you said, we are one with money. And I'm said, are we one with money? What is money and how can we begin to get more of it?
Okay. Well, we want to realize it's a very beautiful energy. It's a spiritual energy and it's essential. It's essential for us all to have to really be empowering in our lives and to be empowering to others. And it is overflowing onto us, and we need to be open to it. The only reason a person really would not have it is if they were to think there was something wrong with it or they'd block it. But there's many blockages about money, fear or thinking it's not good. And we want to really enjoy it, love it, fall in love with it, and realize that it's a symbol of love, and it's actually a symbol of God's love for us. And so we want to be very open to it and enjoy it thoroughly and share it and circulate it as love as well.
Right.
So it's a beautiful energy.
I heard you talk about smelling money. Why is that important? Is that going to bring more money into my listeners' lives?
Well, you know, the reason the Emergency Handbook for Getting Money Fast was ever produced in the first place is that book, which I actually, the first edition, I think, was written at the end of 94. The fifth edition, which is the last one as far as the physical book, was in 99 or 2000, actually, but 99. So it kept expanding, as we say. But the reason that that book was ever available in the first place was that when I moved into my place, I started to make notes for myself about how I was manifesting sums of money during urgent times. Because remember, now I moved in with no job, no money, no way to really or ability to make enough money to live there. And I had been ill. And so I was magically, seriously producing financial supply on an ongoing basis and had to. So I really had to be in synchronicity and use various ways. So for myself, instead of trying to rethink the steps, I started keeping track of what I would do to do it so I could go back to it. And for me, I had called it my Emergency Handbook for Getting Money Fast. And I thought that would be great for everybody to have. And so that's how it was produced. I started to then accumulate these ideas. And believe me, the one about smelling money was a big one because that was a breakthrough one for myself when I had been in a position where it looked like that I just really didn't have enough money at all. In about another week, I would be evicted. And it was that technique that I did for myself to make certain that I wasn't going to feel separated from that money and that I was going to be at one with a tremendous amount of money, period, no matter what it looked like. That was it. And that's what I did consistently. And honestly, at the very end of the week, it did look like I was going to be evicted. And I was very good up until that point, and then I panicked, I think, and I was driving downtown, and I thought, oh my gosh, what am I going to do? My head was spinning, and I didn't know what I was going to do, and how am I going to get out of there, and how am I going to do it? I don't have any money. And I looked across the street, and here is a man just sitting there on the sidewalk. He was crippled, and he was homeless, and I thought, oh my gosh, what am I doing? How could I ever get to the point of thinking this wasn't enough? How silly. So I just seriously thought about everything I had to be grateful for, and really was, and thought, my gosh, I'm in a car, and I've got my body, and I've got my family, and my gosh, I've got my power. And so I took up the last dollar that I had and smelled it, and signed one with a tremendous amount of money, and went back to my apartment and decided to continue with the mail out. This was quite a while ago. It was when we had no internet.
Right.
And so I did the mail out, put all the flyers in a basket by the door, stuffed all the envelopes, no money for stamps, and went to bed and released. And woke up the next morning, and a man had called me from a Chamber of Commerce that hadn't seen me for about a year and said, Carol, I've just wondered how you're doing and have missed you. How's your business? I said, oh, it's just doing great. And he said, well, mine is too. And if you ever need any help, I'd love to give you a hand. And he said, meet me for lunch. And at that time, this is back in the 80s, and wrote me a check for $2,000. And if you never ever need any more, I'm right here. Don't bother paying me back. And I just love helping people who are helping other people. And that to me, honestly, was better than the money, better than the lunch, better
right.
than anything. It was like, oh my gosh, it worked. It worked.
Right.
It worked. So it's the smelling of it and inhaling and just saying, I'm at one with a tremendous amount of money. And that's it, because your subconscious gets the senses. That's how it's impressed. And when you smell it and you state that and you feel at one with it in your heart, it produces. And that to me was just one of the greatest breakthroughs, because I thought what homeless people could do to get off the streets, they could use that to their benefit and could really get into their power with that. So I just felt it was invaluable. And I've been, of course, teaching it ever since. And there's certainly many ways to fine-tune it, but that's basically
right.
it.